Hello students, welcome to zoology class. This is Akmal Hussain, lecturer biology, Square High School and College. Now I am going to take a zoology class of standard 9, chapter 6. Today's topic is blood circulation in human. Circulation of blood through the heart. Last class we have discussed about the structure of heart. Today we have to describe about circulation of heart, circulation of blood through the heart. There is a four pictures which will helpful to describe the blood circulation. You know, heart works by contraction and relaxation. The continuous contraction and relaxation transports blood through the whole body. We have to know about some topics, especially systole. What is systole? The contraction of heart is called systole. I am saying again. Contraction of a heart is called systole. Diastole, contraction of heart is called diastole. And heartbeat, one complete contraction and one diastole combinedly called heartbeat. That means systole, diastole and heartbeat we have learned. Now follow the picture number A. Diastole of atrium. You know, upper two chamber of heart is called atrium, left atrium and right atrium. This is right atrium, this is left atrium. Diastole of atrium, that means relaxation of both atrium. At that time right atrium fill up by deoxygenated blood which entered into by superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. I am saying again, by the help of superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, carbon dioxide induced blood entered into right ventricle, right atrium. On the other hand, by the help of pulmonary vein, oxygenated blood entered into left atrium. Tricuspid and bicuspid valve will close. Picture number B. Systole of atrium. After fill up the both atrium, it start to contract. At that time tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will open. Tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will open. So carbon dioxide induced blood entered into right ventricle and oxygenated blood entered into left ventricle. Picture number C. Systole of ventricle, that means contraction of ventricle. At that time the tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will close. Tricuspid valve and bicuspid valve will close. And semilunar valve will open. This is semilunar valve. This is another semilunar valve. Semilunar valve will open. So carbon dioxide induced blood from right ventricle to entered into pulmonary artery and finally entered into lung. On the other hand, oxygenated blood from left ventricle entered into aorta. Aorta to different artery, different artery to each and every part of our body. Picture number D. Diastole of ventricle, that means relaxation of ventricle. at that time semilunar bulb will close, both semilunar bulb will close and bicuspid and tricuspid bulb will open. So deoxygenated blood entered into right ventricle and oxygenated blood entered into left ventricle. These four steps are there, which combinedly helps to circulate the blood into our body. Functions of heart. You know, main functions of heart. A heart helps blood to keep moving by contraction and relaxation. That means blood is the central pumping organ which helps to supply the blood each and every part of our body, as well as collect the blood with unwanted waste substance back from different part of our body to heart, heart to lung or kidney. Blood vessels. What is blood vessels? The way of blood or the vessels which helps to supply the blood into our different part of the body. That means the way of blood into our body is called blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels are there. Number one, artery. Number two, vein. Number three, capillaries. Artery. What is artery? The blood vessels which carry oxygenated blood away from the heart to different organs of the body are called arteries. Layers of arteries, there are three layers. Number one, tunica externa, that means external layer. Tunica media, that means middle layer. Tunica interna, that means internal layer of artery. There is a picture of artery. This is tunica externa, this one tunica media, and this one tunica interna. And the way through which blood is supplied is called lumen. Characteristics of artery. Number one, the wall of arteries are elastic and thick. Number two, the arteries don't have any valves. It has a narrow passage or lumen. The direction of blood flow is heart to different organs. It carries oxygenated blood. Pulmonary artery is its exception. That means all arteries carry oxygenated blood except pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood. Vein. What is vein? The blood vessels which carry blood from the various organs of the body towards the heart are called veins. Layer of veins like artery. Number one, tunica externa, tunica media, and tunica interna. There is a picture of vein. This one tunica externa, this one tunica media, this one tunica interna, and this is lumen, and this structure is called bulb. This structure is called bulb, and bulb is present in vein where there is artery is not present. Characteristics of vein. Number one, veins originate from the capillaries and end on heart. Veins are thin-walled, less elastic, and have less muscles. It has valves in their comparative wide lumen. That means the lumen of bulb's vein is wider than the artery. It carries deoxygenated blood except pulmonary vein. That means pulmonary vein carries oxygenated blood and all other veins carry deoxygenated blood. That means carbon dioxide enters blood. Thank you, everyone.